Hey there and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Iceflow Studios. And in this tutorial, we're going to be creating rain. We're going to be creating rain using a custom brush that we're going to be creating using brush dynamics. Now to begin, you should probably find an image that you want to apply the rain to. Now it's probably best to find a darker image. This image in front of us I found over at a stock image website, and it's going to be perfect for this example. So to begin, we're going to go over to our brush tool right here, and at the very top we're going to select a nice soft brush. I'm going to select somewhere around right there, nice soft brush, 21. We're going to change that in a minute. Now to access our brush dynamics dialog box, we're going to go to window and then brushes, and here it is. So I'm going to go down the list and I'm going to show you exactly what settings I used. Obviously, depending on the effect that you want, the settings may vary. So we're going to start off by clicking right here where it says brush tip shape, and we're going to adjust a few settings. The first thing we're going to adjust is we're going to adjust the diameter, and that's going to be set to 25 pixels. The angle is going to be set to 90, so it goes from top to bottom. And the roundness is going to be set to 5%. Give it a nice narrow brush. The hardness we're going to keep at 0%, and for spacing we're going to set to 500%. Now depending on how much rain you want on your brush, the higher the spacing, the less rain, and the lower the spacing, the more cluttered together the rain will be. So we're going to set it to 500% for this example. Going down the list, we're going to head into shape dynamics, and we're going to set the size jitter to 100%. Control is going to be off. Minimum diameter, 100%. Angle jitter, 0. Control off. Roundness jitter, 0. Off. And the rest should be fine. Next, we're going to head into scattering and make sure both axes is turned on. We're going to set it to 1000%. Control is off. Count is at 16. Count jitter, 100%, and control is off. So most of the settings are the default settings. And the last thing we're going to look at is other dynamics, which will basically allow us to have some of the rain brushes a little bit more transparent than others. So we're going to set the opacity to 100%, control is off, 100%, and control pen pressure. So very simple settings, nothing too difficult. Now, if you want to save this brush to use it as a later date, use it at a later date, press this button right at the bottom here, which is the Create New Brush button, and name your brush whatever you want. You can name it Rain if you wanted to, and then click OK. So to access this brush, we can go back to our brush tools, go to the very bottom, and choose our saved rain brush right there. Now how do we start creating the rain? Well, we're going to start off by creating a brand new layer. Everything should be on a new layer. And select a color that you think looks like rain. So in this example, I selected this color right over here, sort of like a grayish blue, and then click OK. Now to begin, what we're going to do, we're going to start in the top right corner. You can start at the top left if you want. Click once with your mouse, and then hold down Shift and click at the bottom right corner. And that'll start creating the brush going from top to bottom. Now basically go across the document, so I'm going to click there, click at the bottom, holding down Shift, click there, hold down Shift, click at the bottom, and continue on throughout the document. I'm going to only do half the document just so we can compare it and just not so I waste your time. So there we go, we have a layer with basic rain on it. Now if we head over to our layers palette, we can choose a blending mode. Now some of you may like to choose overlay, some may like to choose soft light, depending on the style of rain that you want. So once you choose it, you can duplicate the layer by holding down Command or Control and press J just to give it a little bit more depth. And there you go. Very basic method of creating rain. It looks pretty realistic. It looks pretty good for a very quick and basic method. Now if you want to adjust some of the settings, head back into Brush Dynamics and adjust the settings accordingly. So if you're looking for more tutorials, head over to tutcast.com. If you're looking for a Photoshop community, head over to photoshoptalent.com. Until next time, this is Howard from Iceflow Studios. Take care.